What's poppin', Lambert? I'm Cameron Jackson.
And I'm Kirk Kunick.
And you're watching LHS Live. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Lambert Hosa is having its annual Spring Blood Drive on March 21st. If you are 16 and older and are interested in donating, sign up in the cafeteria during 5th and 6th lunch. Donors will receive free t-shirts.
The Lambert Photo Team is looking for photographers for the 2018-2019 school year. If you love taking pictures and capturing memories, go to the Photo Team application website and fill out the form.
Do you want to help people in the Dominican Republic who have medical needs? Lambert's Medical Science Academy is traveling to the Dominican Republic during the upcoming spring break. Our students will be building water stations and providing healthcare supplies to families in need. Did you know that often girls in developing nations don't go to school 1 week a month? You can make a direct contribution to improving lives and school access to girls in the region by donating medical supplies such as Tylenol, Band-Aids, Neosporin, bandages, water purification tablets, ACE bandages, and feminine hygiene products. If you would like to donate items, please drop them off in room 2309. Thank you for making a difference in the world.
There will be a pep rally today during third period. The updated bell schedule for today is located right here.
Please help National English Honor Society with their annual book drive. We're collecting books of all genres for all ages to donate to a local charity. The drive ends today, and books can be dropped off in Ms. Harrison's room, 2813, or the Media Center. Service hours are also available for club members in NEHS, NHS, Beta, NSSHS, and SNHS. Thank you for your support.
There are over 2 billion school-aged individuals living in the world today. That's more young people than any other time in human history. And it's this generation's creativity, their actions, their art, their poetry, their protests, their questions, their code, their dreams. It's this generation's ideas that will define the future of our world. One well-articulated idea can reach and inspire millions.
Exhilarating.
Innovating.
Curiosity.
Contagious.
Oh my gosh, worthwhile.
Inspiring.
Eye-opening. Oh, that's two words technically, but one word if you put a hyphen, eye-opening.
First things first, rest in peace, sucker fair. For real, you the only father that I ever knew. I get my shit pregnant, I'ma be a better you. Prophecies that I made way back in the veil. For fear, listen, even back when we was broke, my team ill. Martin Luther King would have been on Dreamville, talk to him. One time for my LA sisters, one time for my LA. Ladies, you can't tell the difference. One time for a girl who knows. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved. 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 No role models, and I'm here right now. No role models to speak of. Searching through my memory, I couldn't find one. Last night I was getting my feet rubbed by the baddest shit. Not Trina, but I swear to God, it's good to make you call your girl up and tell her, hey, what's good? Sorry, I'm never coming home, I'ma stay for good. Then hang the phone up and proceed to lay the wood. I ain't fast like 911 in white neighborhoods. Ain't got no shame about it. She think I'm spoiled and I'm rich cause I can have any bitch. I got defensive and said, nah, I was the same without it. But then I thought back to a better me. Before I was a B-list celebrity, before I started calling this so heavily. Back when you could get a platinum plaque without no melody, you weren't sweating me. One time for my L.A. sisters, one time for my L.A. Ladies, you can't tell the difference. One time for a nigga who knows.
just finished up our second month of training. We started out the first couple weeks just kind of introducing the guys back to the weight room after Christmas break with a general preparatory phase. And once that was over, we started a general strength phase that lasted about 4 weeks. We saw a lot of good gains. And now we've just started our first week of our max strength phase. And that's a 4 week phase that we're going to do up until spring break. And we're really, really pushing the kids and bringing the intensities up. To get stronger, you got to lift a lot of heavy weight. And that's exactly what we're doing the next 4 weeks. So, and then we'll test out right before we leave for spring break and see how much stronger we've actually gotten.
Hey, horns on three. 1, 2, 3.
Horns!
All right, gentlemen, real quick. Hey, it's the end to a good week. All right, first week of max strength. All right, I know y'all felt a little bit of a difference, right, in the intensity. Okay, so we got to bring it. We got to raise the bar every single time you enter this room. Understand?
Yes,
all right, I want Daniel Park to come up here. Where's Park? There he is. Park's our reigning January Athlete of the Month. All right. And today we're going to announce our February Athlete of the Month, okay?
Yeah.
Remember, this guy, the next Athlete of the Month, has perfect attendance in the month of February, all right? He's made some huge gains in his Power Clean, I think over 40 pounds since we tested last, and he's gained over 7 pounds in the month of February, okay? And he's a leader. He's been a leader on the field and a leader in this room, okay? So remember, guys, this chain represents each and every one of you, okay? And we're only as strong as the weakest link in this chain. Understand? Okay?
Yes,
so, without further ado, Mr. Nathan Smith is here! Yeah. February Athlete of the Month was Nathan Smith. He's been a great player for us. He worked his way in the starting lineup last season, played a lot of inside linebacker for us, and then we moved him outside due to an injury and just was a seamless transition for him. He's just that caliber of athlete. He can play just about anywhere on the field, and he's carried that over into this offseason, working hard, training, great intensity, and he's just a great leader for our football team. Hook him.
Now let's take a moment of silence to pause and reflect on our efforts, commitments, and goals for this school day.
Thanks for tuning in, Lambert, and we'll see you next week. Hook 'em horns.